The human voice is the product of a complex process. It all begins with air passing between the vocal folds, causing them to vibrate, which results in the generation of sound waves. When the vocal folds are seen in coronal view, instead of being thin, band-like structures, they are actually wedge-shaped triangles. Furthermore, when the vocal folds vibrate against each other, there is both a horizontal and vertical component. There is a mucosal wave that starts at the lower margin that opens first, resulting in a convergent shape due to tracheal air pressure. When the upper margin opens up, releasing a puff of air, the lower edges of the vocal fold covers come back together, resulting in a divergent shape. The cycle is then repeated. Each air puff released during one complete vibration cycle is one cycle of the sound wave that we recognize as voice. The vocal fold membrane or cover moves freely and separately from the vocal fold muscle as a result of the action of the air flowing through the glottis. This movement is wave-like, like a ripple over the surface of a pond, and it is known as the mucosal wave. Changes in pitch can alter how the vocal folds vibrate. As pitch increases, cricothyroid muscle activation causes the vocal folds to elongate and thin out, reducing the difference between the upper and lower margins. Vocal fold vibration speeds up, resulting in more vibration cycles completed per second. If we take a closer look, the vocal fold is actually comprised of five layers: mucosa, superficial lamina propria in gray, the vocal ligament in purple, which is comprised of the intermediate and deep lamina propria, and finally muscle. The vocal fold mucosal epithelium, due to its pliability, oscillates independently of the deeper layers due to the superficial lamina propria, which is a loose gel-like structure. This layer acts like a cushion for the mucosa, thereby reducing mechanical stress on the deeper structures and allowing it to freely move. Vocal cord nodules can develop with aggressive voice use, leading to callus-like growths on the vocal cords, resulting from abnormal thickening of the mucosal epithelium at the point of maximum contact between the two vocal fold sides. This may lead to a raspy-sounding voice, as the nodules may disrupt the mucosal wave. The normally cyclic and symmetric vibration of the vocal folds during phonation now becomes asymmetric and irregular. When small, the raspy voice mainly occurs in the higher pitches, where the vocal fold vibration is most narrow. As the nodules become larger, it starts to affect the lower pitch ranges. A vocal cord cyst can similarly affect the voice, but instead of thickening of the mucosal lining as occurs with a nodule, it is an actual mass typically present within the superficial lamina propria layer. A vocal cord polyp, just like a nodule, affects the mucosal lining, but instead of a callus-like appearance, it has a more blister-like appearance. Just as with a cyst and nodule, it can affect the voice by disrupting the vocal fold vibration. Not only can a raspy voice occur due to organic pathology, but also from functional impairment such as muscle tension dysphonia. In this condition, the muscle is too tight, causing the vocal folds to be compressed more firmly into each other than normal. This vocal fold compression essentially smothers the mucosal wave, causing the vibration to be irregular and unpredictable. In the opposite extreme, a weak and breathy voice can occur when the vocal folds do not come together, leaving a persistent gap. This may occur with a vocal cord paralysis or when the vocal fold muscles become very weak, leading to vocal fold bowing. During phonation, air leaks out between the vocal folds, resulting in a breathy and weak-sounding voice.